Morning, Jack. Good morning, Catherine. Good morning, Jill. Well, Jill's there somewhere. So what would you like to do today? Should we move on to a new move? Yes?
Oh, I'm Jack. Not ready yet.
Jack says yes.
Oh, yes. Okay.
Jill?
Okay.
Jill, are you ready to move on to a new move?
I'm not even ready to be awake yet.
Well, I think we should go ahead and try it with the understanding that we're not going to get it. It's just an introduction, so don't sweat it. We'll watch it a couple of times. We'll watch move 8, 9, 10, and I think this is move 11 we'll be working on. And we'll just look at move 11 a couple times and then give it a shot. So hold on.
8. Yep. Have some plates in your hand. Left hand, right hand, push down, head, pull up, head is pulling up, arms, push down, you know. Arms, hands are pushing down, head is pulling up. Then, number 9, number 10, easy for you to remember, because number 9, number 10 is both with the claws. After the plates, first, bring both hands up to the chamber. Feel your lungs, feel your breathing. Then, already from here, when the right hand starts, the eyes, yeah, see this hand here. Concentrate on this hand here. And with the eyes, and when you open, you see, follow. Here, be careful when you go now here to the side. The left shoulder, don't open too much like this. What we want with the arm crossing your chest is that it closes down one part of the lung and the other one is more free. Yeah, and if you stay like this, then here the right one is like squeezed a little bit. Yeah, and when you stand here, relax. Stay inside of you, relax. This one, take the position. And now breathe. Breathe and feel inside. Feel, compare left lung, right lung. When you breathe like this, how does it feel? When you breathe like this, how does it feel? Yeah, and you realize when you're here, the left one breathes more. The left one feels a little bit more cold. Yeah, and when you're here, left one is closed, right one is open. Yeah, feels different. breathe in and out. Number 10. Come down. Already. When I make it, when I come down, I know what's going to be the next movement. I need to face my body like this. So, I come down. And almost here. Here now, my hip turns already. Down. Already halfway now here. And 12, those arms sink, cross, close the ears, like newborn. emphasis, concentration on the drums. Concentrate on the drums. Don't concentrate on the pain. And just go. So, and when you're down, hold. One, two, three, and then you go up. Open. And down again. And last one.
Okay, so let's just do 11. That's a pretty simple move.
I mean, nothing is simple with this guy.
Well, he's certainly limber. So for that move, you do that twice.
That's like newborn.
I mean, it's hitting that pretty important spot,
yeah,
at the base of the skull. But I'm just wondering if there's a specific application for that. What is something to do with that?
Well, there, you know, there's two columns of muscles that come up on either side of the, and then if you go out from those a little bit, there are two acupuncture points, and I can't remember the name of them, but they call them colloquially the drums. And, you know, you know where they are. You can feel them. They're actually the base of the skull itself, and they're the place where the muscles and tendons attach to the skull, and they get a tremendous amount of workout during the day because most of us don't actually stay upright. Even he doesn't always stay upright. They're often a little strained forward, so these become a little inflamed, and that kind of just sort of drumming on them really helps relax them. Well, at least that's been my experience of them. So You can start with that. You can play with that and then see where it takes you.
Maybe I should just do that all the time. Actually,
maybe you should. Yeah.
Because, yeah, when I get a migraine, I have this stuff called Ted's Pain Cream, and that's the first place I apply it, there in the tunnels. So, yeah, that would make sense.
They're
you know, in San Francisco, if you did that, no one would notice. So I think you should. Tap your head all the time.
You could walk down the street doing this. No one would pay any attention.
Well, what's the purpose of suddenly detach your hands off your ears? Why does it?
That's something I mentioned last time. That's something that Master Feng would do too. Now this guy did it by actually covering his ears.
Yeah.
And then pop. Master Feng would do it by putting his fingers in his ear, and then he would go pop like that. So he would make a little joke out of it. But he would do it 5 or 6 times. So it's a good example of the fact that there is a language of movements in Qigong. And they show up in all kinds of different places and different varieties. But actually, they're all part of some really large language of movements and whatever. What are you doing when you do that?
And he said, you're being like a newborn after that.
Exactly.
I mean, I would love this feeling, especially twice in a row. I mean, like.
Well, if you think about his metaphor, what you're doing, your sense of hearing is very large. But unlike our eyes, it's largely unconscious. We don't generally pay very much attention to it. If someone's speaking to us or something, or there's some loud, unusual noise. But most of the time, we just go through our lives. We're actually hearing things all the time, but we sort of don't pay much attention to it. When you try this, do it yourself right now. When you close your ears, now say something. Everybody say something, all right? Your voice sounds so strange.
Yeah, it's like being underwater. Yeah.
It's like being underwater or worse. So what he was saying is, it's like the transition period between death and rebirth. It's a different dimension. And it's with us all the time, but we don't pay any attention to it.
Between death and rebirth?
Yes. Yes. So it's what he says. It's like, it's like being born again. That's exactly what he said. So what he's saying is it's an opening of your sensorium. You close your senses and then you open your senses. And when you open your senses, wow, it's just like being born again. Well, if that's like being born again, that means this is like not being born again. Where are you when you're not born? All right. It's an interesting question. He was making a little joke out of it, but if you actually stop and think about it, it's an interesting question. I think it's another example, and if you look through this routine and the other routines, you'll find other examples of it, of kind of washing your senses. Mm-hmm. You kind of wash them out a little bit, just to clean everything. And I think this is just pop, pop. Pop is just a way of taking it into the shower and washing it a little bit, right? And starting all over again for the day. Okay, there's my lecture for the day. So I would, if I were you, I would go ahead and try move number 11 a couple of times, then go back and do the whole routine and finish up with a little fangzong gong. All right, Jack, take it away.
Okay, we're going to be born again Buddhists, not born again Christians, okay?
I'm Jewish, so that's fine.
So am I.
You could be a Jew-boo.
A Jew-boo. We're Jew-boos, yeah.
I like that.
So we'll do 11 a few times, okay? Maybe a total of 4. All right, 4 whatevers, bending over. Start tapping. Okay, that's enough. You know, I noticed he keeps his legs straight when he bends over and he goes all the way down.
Yeah, I can't do that, but
I can't
big
do that.
Show anymore. Off. Yeah.
I know, big show off. So you want to run through from the beginning one time?
Yes.
All right.
I mean, Jill, are you okay with it?
Oh yeah. Yeah. Okay. I'll have to accommodate for my my toe situation. No going up on the toes.
Okay. No toes for Jill.
Yeah, my ballet career is over.
All right. What's the next one? Like this? Oh, yeah.
It's intense.
I know.
I mean, even this tapping stuff.
Yeah.
It's not that the move is difficult by itself, but I don't know. Suddenly you are really inside yourself. Maybe
yeah.
Because you cover your ears.
Yeah. Yeah, it's a pretty tiring little routine.
Yes, it is. Especially at night.
Yeah, I know. I know. I couldn't do it at the time you're doing it. What time is it there now?
It's a quarter to seven.
Quarter to seven. All right. So let's do some Fang Sun Gong. I'm going to just change the order in the interest of time. Okay.
Okay.
So we'll start with the Yang Qi clears tension and then whatever.
Thank you very much, Doc.
Thank you all.
I feel very relaxed right now.
Good. Good. Don't chill out for the night.
Okay, guys. Wishing you a good day.
All right.
That's good. Go chill out, guys. We'll see you. We'll see you all tomorrow.
I won't be here tomorrow.
Yeah, me neither.
I'll see you all Thursday.
And we'll see you all on Thursday.
All right.
Okay.
Bye-bye.